So moving to zeta potential in more detail. I'll explain what zeta potential is and why it's important. That leads to an explanation of the concept of the electrical double layer. At this point, people often throw their hands up. It's seen as too complicated. But I will describe it at a level that's sufficient for your needs. I won't go into the deep theories of the double layer. I'll give you just the essential information that you need to have to be able to understand and challenge the assumptions, and whether you believe they're valid or not for your particular case. How do charged particles with their double layers and zeta potentials behave in an electric field? That's to say, the phenomenon of electrophoresis. How do you calculate zeta potential from electrophoretic mobility? Electrophoresis is the measurable phenomenon of your sample. Zeta potential is the property you want to obtain. There's a relationship between the two, which I'll describe. There are three things that relate to the confidence that you can have in the calculation of zeta potential from the mobility: the selection of the appropriate mathematical model, the assumptions made by the models, and the validity of the models in the real world. In some instances, it'll be straightforward. You will be confident with the values you calculate. In other cases, you'll decide the assumptions are not valid. But can you still make use of the information? How is electrophoretic mobility measured using electrophoretic light scattering? I'll describe the principle of operation. I won't go into complex light scattering theory, just the basic concepts. What are the main assumptions associated with the measurement? Under what conditions are the assumptions valid, and under what conditions are they most likely invalid? And what can you do about it?